Heat is energy, but most of the heat we produce from our bodies, homes, cars, and even this electric bike just dissipates into the environment. It's a huge waste in an energy-strapped world.
But what if there was a way to efficiently turn that heat directly into electricity? A fabric that could be worn like a second skin while helping to power our e-lifestyles. And that's all science, no fiction.
All of this is going to be packaged in soft, stretchy materials.
Hand-mounting tiny metal posts is not the most glamorous job for a highly trained engineer.
Yeah, you can't do this after drinking coffee.
But these semiconductors have a superpower. They're the vital organs of a new kind of wearable electronic device that can convert body heat into electricity.
When I was in high school, there was the movie called Iron Man.
In the movie, Tony Stark develops a suit of armor that gives him all sorts of superhuman powers.
That's the point that I decided to do the research on wearable electronics. I thought I could be the next Tony Stark.
But Han and Mohammed Malakouti don't want to use their devices to battle enemies. They want to generate electricity.
You know, our body generates heat and dissipates it to the environment. And this idea for wearable thermoelectric devices is that let's recover that heat and use it for powering small electronics or wearable sensors.
Think things to monitor health, like your temperature and heart rate.
So how do these thermoelectric devices convert heat to electricity?
Well, when you link certain metals together and expose one end to heat, it causes the electrons to flow towards the colder side. That's electricity. This phenomenon is called the Seebeck effect.
But the cool thing is, the more you increase the difference in temperature between the two ends, say by adding a block of ice to the top here, the more electricity it makes.
But maintaining that temperature gradient is harder than you'd think. It's so difficult, the lab has spent 5 years solving this and other engineering challenges.
And we want to increase the surface area because we want to dissipate more heat on the cold side.
They've developed stretchable, 3D printed layers that insulate the cold and hot sides from each other.
Yeah, that looks really good to me.
And the proof of their success? A tiny red light.
There is no energy storage device, there is no battery, nothing. The LED gets light up the moment you place this device on the body, converting the heat to electricity.
It's the moment they knew they had achieved something that had never been done before.
It was great.
Powering LED with your body heat at the room temperature, this is like huge jump from the status quo.
That feels powerful.
Okay, is it fashionable too?
It is very fashionable. It does feel cold.
Yeah.
It feels almost like, not a piece of ice, but definitely like a piece of metal.
Yeah, because it's dissipating heat for you.
It could also be used in factories to make electricity from hot pipes and machinery instead of heating up the room.
We are not trying to use more energy to do this. So We want any kind of like waste heat, we wanted to capture it and put it into a good use.
And if you need to wrap the converter around a hot pipe or have it bend to maintain contact with someone's skin as they move around, being flexible is very important.
Hana Malakouti's thermoelectric device isn't just flexible, it's stretchy as well. Yeah! maybe not that stretchy.
But a lab test shows just how stretchable it can be while still conducting electricity.
Yeah, we don't want to squeeze it too hard. Let's see how far it can go.
The setup is simple. Clamp the device in to see how far it can stretch and still keep the electricity flowing.
Ready?
At 150% the original length, electricity still flows easily. 200%, 300%. The beep means no more flow.
I lost the connection.
Yeah, that was almost 400% strain.
That's more than the wearable device would ever likely need to stretch in the real world. And this all works because of another feature of the new design: liquid wires. Most metals are solid at temperatures comfortable to humans, but not gallium.
And if you mix gallium and indium together, you get something called a eutectic alloy, which means the melting point of the mix is even lower. It's liquid at room temperature.
You can use this liquid instead of solid wires to conduct electricity. Liquid metal wires don't break as they're stretched. They morph to fill the space.
And we can repeat this as many times as we want. Reshape it, reform it. That's the beauty of having liquid conductor.
Malakuti and Han have accomplished something incredible with their innovative designs, but their devices are not going to be powering our cities anytime soon.
This is not going to address the energy crisis in the world, but as standalone, as self-sustainable electronics devices.
Health monitors, weather gauges, smart kitchens, maybe even converting heat waste from electric vehicle batteries back into usable electricity.
I kind of feel like I'm a dreamer. Like, how can we push the boundaries? Looks really good. Good job. I feel like we are discovering new phenomena. We are showing new applications, possibilities that is going to maybe at some point change our lives.
And in a world that seems to need more and more energy every day, tapping into waste heat to help power our lives is a tantalizing solution.
What would you call Iron Man if he was built from the technology you're creating?
I would say I just want to name it with my name.
Young man.
Yeah, young man. Young man.
Let me close this because I don't want to spill the beans. The beans.
So much smoke.
Oh my God, it felt like I was in a volcano.
OPB members are vital to the work we do. You're the power that makes all science no fiction go. Thanks for your ongoing support. And don't miss out on any of OPB's science, environment, and arts programs by subscribing to OPB Insider at opb.org/allscience.
Nailed it.